In this video, let's talk about whether you should have just a one-time event or an event series.
This video is brought to you by Appy Pie's Academy.
And the rule of thumb is that if you're starting out in event marketing, creation, your first event that you put on is going to be your worst. It's not a comment on you. It's the case for most people because everything is new. Event planning, event management, event marketing is new. It's very hard to get it all right. And you find your mistakes after your first event. So many people that I see, a disproportionate number of people, want to put on just one event. And my recommendation is actually to have more than one event, hopefully a recurring event series, because events only grow and get better over time. And what happens is that after your first event, you identify the mistakes you make and you fix those mistakes, and you can do a lot of things to discover your mistakes. You can send out a survey to your attendees to see what can be better next time, what they liked, what they didn't like. And that first event, and really every event, is your chance to meet your attendees in person and ask them in person, what do you like? What's not great? How can I make it better for you? And in the next events and the future, every future event, you make it better and better and better. And over time, it becomes great. Not only the management, but also the marketing becomes much, much better. You grow your email list, you grow your audience. Everything is easier long term. The first one's the hardest, the least people show up, and all the mistakes happen there. So events, they really flourish over time. And it's especially the case if it's your first time, if you're new to events, and especially if you want to grow a attendance who pays and generate revenue from event and maybe sell things from your events to your attendees. Well, guess what? The more engaged your audience is, the bigger the audiences are every time in terms of attendance. So bigger attendances and attendances who enjoy your events more, they'll buy more from you also. And regular attendees will be more likely to buy because you will have had more contact points with them and they will warm up to buying from you over long term. So everything is better. Attendance, revenue, over time. And so that's why I recommend having a longer term outlook for your events. Now, there are a few exceptions, like maybe you have events like a conference or a one-time fundraiser or a one-time party or a one-time concert where the band is not coming back and you just need to do it once. Well, some of these things like parties, you know, you can put them on often, and fundraisers too. You can restructure how you position your fundraiser into a regularly occurring kind of an event, not just a one-time fundraiser. But in case you have something like a conference that really does might only happen once a year, you really need to build up an audience. And one of the greatest ways to build up an audience is from smaller previous events. For example, if you run small events, even if you don't have a conference, but like, let's say you sell a weekend retreat. Guess what? If you had smaller events leading up to that, the people who attended that and who came back and again and again and again, they're the perfect people to sell your retreat to. They're the perfect people to sell a bigger conference to, a whole weekend event. They're really good audience to build because you already know that they like attending your events. You're half of the way there. And in addition to that, you can look to build additional audiences in maybe your community, maybe online if your event is something that draws people from all over the country or the world. If you have a local event, though, of course, you want to only focus on your local area. So the online strategies of building up an audience online don't really work because your audiences will be from all over the world or the country, but you only need people locally. But if you do have a national level event, then of course you want to build up thought leadership online. But if you don't have an audience elsewhere and you do need to promote your one-time event and really get a lot of people in there, then the other solutions are you can run ads, which means you need some money. You can get publicity from industry publications. For example, if you had your own audience, it's kind of like getting your own publicity because you can reach a lot of people. But if you cannot reach a lot of people with your own audience, then you want to tap into journalists and bloggers and influencers who already do cover your subject matter so that you can leverage their audience and get the word out. Of course, you want to reach out to your local community. And really, if you do have a one-time event and it's approaching, it's really all about extra hustle, maybe more flyers, more social media, more relationship building with people in your community, in your subject matter, so that maybe you can tap into their audiences and get a little bit of reach through them. And little by little, you will get that attendance built up to your one-time event. But the truth is, if you can make it a regularly occurring thing, it will be much, much better.